Hi, I'm Patu from FreeFinCal. Which index fund should I use? Should I use one tracking the Nifty or the Sensex is a question that's often been asked. I had already shown this difference between Sensex and Nifty returns in a previous post, but let's just talk about it one more time, especially in the context of concentration risks. So as everybody knows, Nifty has 50 stocks and Sensex has 30 stocks, both of them being traded in the different exchanges. But typically, there will not be much of a difference in the top 30 stocks of both indices, but just about the weights would change. But I'll do a deeper analysis of differences in another post. In October 2020, Reliance Industries occupies 15% of the Nifty and 17% of the Sensex. HDFC Bank 9.6% in the Nifty and 10.5% in the Sensex. So obviously, because there are less number of stocks in the Sensex and because they are both based on free float market capitalization, clearly the stock with the highest market cap will have the highest weightage. There's nothing one can do about it. Is it the right thing to do? Is it the right thing, or should there be a weight capping? Is a debatable point in indexology, but that's how it is. So let's take a look at the price movement. You can see this is from June 1999. If you look at this, there's not much of a difference. The red is Nifty, the black is Sensex. Both of them total returns index. There's not really much of a difference. But if you look at the 1 year rolling return difference, so the 1 year return difference is basically the Sensex 1 year return minus Nifty 1 year return on the same dates. And this is the return difference is shown on the left axis. On the right axis, you have the Nifty, which is the orange line, and the return difference is obviously the yellow line. You can see in the past, there have been significant differences in the Sensex and Nifty returns. But then in the last decade, that is from 2010 onwards, more or less, there has been relatively a stable return difference, even in the 1 year, even in the very short term. It's not been not more than 2% on either side, 2 or 3% or maximum 4%, minus 4% and about 2-3% on the positive side. Beyond that, it's not been much of a difference. Over 1 year, over 3 years, the return difference significantly has gone down again in the last decade, about 1-2%. And over 5 years, again, you can see it's very close, just a little bit touch below. The Nifty has been trailing a little bit below for most part of last decade, and then it's picked up a little bit. It's just too small to say anything. And you can see over the 10-year period, you can see not much of a difference. It's really minuscule. So this Nifty versus Sensex argument is really not going to make much of a difference to the investor. You can choose whatever you want. One can ask, should I add more stocks? Will the concentration problem come down? Nifty 100, it has got 100 stocks, but just 13% exposure to a single stock and 8.4% to HDFC Bank. And 13% to Reliance Industries. Even when you have 500 stocks, 10%, 10.4% goes to Reliance and 6.7% goes to HDFC. So relatively, yes, the concentration risk has come down, but on an absolute level, the concentration risk is very much there. And if you are going to add more stocks, then the fund manager will find it more tougher, the tracking error will be more, the expense ratio will be more, and so on. So it's really, there's no much of a benefit. Might as well stick to Sensex or Nifty. If you're too worried about concentration risk between Sensex and Nifty, you just choose the Nifty and be done with it. So that's about it. What is remarkable is if you take the Nifty Next 50, the concentration risk drops by half. It's 50% reduction. And that is because of the mid-cap-ish like nature of those stocks, they don't have much of a market cap. In India, truly speaking, there are probably like 20 or 15 true large caps, and then it drops thick and fast. So that's about it. I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.